Let's start off with poverty. Topics to be covered: introduction, meaning of poverty, who are poor, measures of poverty, that is relative and absolute, concept of poverty in India, the number of poor in India, causes of poverty, government approach to remove poverty, poverty alleviation programs in India, critical evaluation of poverty alleviation. Let's see a small intro of poverty. In the previous chapter, we have studied the economic policies perceived by India. Then after independence and the outcome of this policy with the relations to the various development indicator. So in this previous chapter, we have learned that after independence, they have brought up with the new policies and we'll be calling it as a 5-year plans, economic systems or what else may be. In the 5-year plans, they are focused mainly on poverty alleviate, that is reduction of poverty and increase the standard of living of a people. The 5-year plan have always stressed on upliftment of poor people and achieving a minimum standard of living for all. Yes, poverty is a challenge not only for India but for the entire world, as more than 1/5 of the world poor. Around 270 million people live in India alone and are unable to meet with their basic needs. Now let's move on to the other one. What is poverty? Poverty is hunger. Poverty is lack of shelter. Poverty is being a sick, not treated, being able to see a doctor. Poverty is not having access to school and not knowing how to read. Poverty is not having a job, fear for the future, living one day at a time. Poverty is losing a child to illness brought about by unclean water. Poverty is powerlessness, lack of representation and freedom. So by this, I think you know what is mean by poverty. Poverty is nothing but hunger, lack of shelter, sick, not being able to see a doctor, and not having access to a school, and fear for the future, losing the children because of illness and unclean water, and lack of representation and freedom, calling it as a poverty. Now let's move on to the other one. Meaning of poverty. Poverty refers to a state in which an individual is unable to fulfill even the basic necessities of life. The minimum requirement included food, clothing, housing, education and health facilities. So in this, the people those who are unable to meet with the minimum requirement like a food, clothing and housing, education, health facilities will be calling it as a poverty. Yes? Now, who are poor? Starvation and hunger are the key features of the poorest household. The poor lack basic literacy and skills and have very limited economic opportunity. Poor people also face unstable employment. Yes, and then we'll just move on to poor in rural and poor in urban. Now, first we'll look at urban area. Urban areas poor people include pushcart vendors, street cobblers, rag pickers, beggars, etc. So these people will come under in a urban poor. Where they will reside? They reside in kaccha hutments. Yes, and how the houses will made? The houses with walls made of mud and roofs made of grass and bamboo as well as wood. Yes, and in this, the urban poor are largely the overflow of the rural poor who had migrated to urban area in the search of alternative employment as well as livelihood. So what happened in the urban poor? More number of people, they have start migrated to rural to urban. Why they are migrating from rural to urban? For searching of job in the urban area. Now, yes, the poor includes landless agricultural laborers, cultivators with very small holdings, landless laborers. Many of the rural peoples are landless. So in the rural areas, the people will include in the rural areas poverty, landless agricultural laborers, cultivators. Cultivators with very small holdings, that is landless laborers. Many of the rural poor people are landless. So the people, those who are not having land for the cultivation, they will come under in a rural poverty. And many rural poor do not get even 2 meals a day. Yes, now let's move on to the other one. Characteristics of poor people. What are characteristics? Hunger, starvation, malnutrition. Second, poor health. Third, limited economic opportunities. Fourth, debt trap. Fifth, lack of facilities of electricity and water. Sixth, gender inequality. Seventh, bigger families. Hunger, starvation, malnutrition. Starvation and hunger are the basic problem of the poorest household, and malnutrition is alarmingly high among the poor. Next, we'll just move on to poor health. They are generally physically weak due to illness. Yes, and disability or serious illness. The children are less likely to survive or be born healthy. Next, limited economic opportunities. They have very limited economic opportunities due to lack of literacy as well as skill. Because of lack of skill as well as literacy, they have very limited economic opportunities, and apart from that, they face unstable employment and unable to negotiate their legal wages, and most of the employees are exploited. Debt trap. They borrow money from the money lender who charge high rate of interest that push them into chronic indebtedness. Who do not have access to electricity. Their primary cooking fuel is firewood and cow dung cake. A large section of poor people do not even have access to safe drinking water. So, mostly the poor people, they do not have any electricity. And apart from that, the cooking fuel, it's like a firewood as well as a cow dung cake. And even a large section of poor people do not get even a safe drinking water. Gender inequality is one of the reasons for a poverty. Gender inequality prevails within a family in regards to participation of gainful employment, education and decision making. So, what to tell it? Gender inequality, giving more preference for a male child. The poor farm families are bigger in size, which make their economic condition worse. So, these are the characteristics of poor people.